West personality, Bob Natimali from Kingston, Jamaica. Bob, what brings you to St. Martin?
Well, just a pass through, you know, I go to Jamaica, so I stop cross if I come from Brazil.
What are you doing in Brazil, Bob?
We are doing some record promotion business.
This last album, Survival, how is it doing now?
Well, I think maybe it do good, you know. Do all right. Do as I expected.
Let's talk about Rastafarianism in the Caribbean. Right now, the Rasta movement is very big in the Caribbean. A lot of people look at you, Bob, as being a prophet. Would you say that you're a prophet?
No, I'm the Rasta man.
And what exactly does that mean?
Rasta man means that we black people recognize our identity and go and keep it. So, you know, Rasta is our one. It's like how Russia have Marx and Lenin, America have capitalism, black people have Rasta, which is African.
Would you say that came way back from Ethiopia?
Yeah, way forward from Ethiopia, from the black man tradition, from the beginning of time till now.
The song that you sing, Wake Up and Live, and also this one, there's so much trouble in the world today. Is that a special message you're trying to get across to the people here in the Caribbean?
Yes, all our music is always awaken the people of the prison situation that I'm about to right now, you know. So, them songs are related to today's crisis. So much trouble in the world. Our people must wake up now and live, you know. What do you figure?
What about us black people here in the Caribbean? What would you say, these present time we're going through a whole lot of trials and tribulations with the capitalist system and the socialist system. What sort of advice do you have for the people in the Caribbean at this time?
You see, the people is always innocent, you know. It's like government and the leaders always carry themselves into situation and make believe that the people is with them. But what really happened is that now is the end of the time. You know?
You feel like we're living in the last days?
Yeah, this is the last days. Now is the black people time to really recognize themselves and deal with it properly. Because over a period of thousands of years, we've been the subject of the white man, which is not so well, and we feel anything like any big color prejudice thing or go on or anything, but it's just that we black people must recognize ourselves and deal with it now, you know, because we are a people and not just slaves, you know.
Bob, tell me something. What about this marijuana thing as far as Rastafarianism is concerned? Is it something very sacred to Rastas?
Well, as you know, that herb is healing of the nation, and Rastaman use herb. Government all over the world fight against herb because they know if everyone smoke herb, most naturally people are going to communicate better together. You understand? If everybody drink rum, then everyone will be drunk and communication won't be no dear. So as long as you're drunk, you can always be being slaves. Once you smoke herb, it's like your soul searching for freedom, you know? And when you smoke herb, your soul get that freedom to help your physical structure to get it too. And once you drink the rum, which is, it keeps you down.
It
break you down and make you easy to control. Because when time the rum wear off, you return to your job. You know what I mean? It don't really make you, it don't make you see, yeah, it don't construct nothing at all. Herb is a thing now where it constructs. When you smoke it, it meditates of good things, not of evil. But through them know that now, through the government of the world, some of them don't even know. Some of them is only follow fashion, you know? Yeah, follow the next traditional slave mentality bring down. But herb is for the people, man, and we will always smoke herb.
A lot of people in the Caribbean associate Rastafarianism with crime. What do you have to say on this?
Well, I am saying that the people who is running the world today, they are the crimers, because not one of them is doing the right thing. All of them is outlaw. The Rastaman is the only righteous man upon the face of the earth. All government is illegal. All government in the world today is illegal.
See, we as Rastaman don't live.
This is Jacob Killer Miller, and he's here. And what you were saying now, Jacob?
We as Rastaman, we don't live by man law. We live by God law. Saying? That means we don't really check for them man law with them a precept for black people from the search. Saying? Because we've been so oppressed all these years that we're tired of that now as black people. Saying? So you as a black man for realize to teach your people a man as a man who interview people at all times and show them truth and right. Because it makes sense we alone preach the truth and only practice it, you know, and do it. Yeah.
We're also talking to Jacob Killer Miller, who just released an album too. Jacob, can you talk a little bit about this album you released?
Which album?
The one with Inner Circle, the very latest one.
Oh, well, the album with Inner Circle is on which the same label as Bob Island record. Same. And there's a whole heap of different communication of songs on it, which is smoking is good for the brain, which we are showing the people. Say cocaine is not for black people.
And some people feel, Jacob, that you've adopted a sort of rock pop style on this album. Would you say that?
No, well, let's see, I play many kind of music, and I lay the music as a foundation, which is reggae. See? And afterwards, I put anything else on top of that, but the foundation is reggae. You know, see? But you can't have every man come out of the same place playing the same thing. We have to have different varieties, and variety is the spice of life. And as Rastaman, I have to show them in diplomacy, because God shows the children of Israel shall come in diplomacy. So I have to show the people them.
You've been a Rasta all of your life, Jacob?
Well, from my born until now, I know about Rasta, and I live the principle of Rasta. See?
Okay, let's just talk to Junior Mervin, and he's also the lead guitarist of Bob Marley's group. Junior, welcome to St. Martin.
Hi, how you doing?
What are your impressions of Bob Island?
Well, you have a beautiful island here. The only problem, I think, is a bit of colonialism. You know what I mean?
You've been with Bob Marley from ever since the inception of the group?
Well, I joined the group in 77 on the Exodus album. I must point out that my name is not Mervin, my name is
Marvin. Junior Marvin.
There's also a singer from Jamaica who's a very good singer. His name is Junior Mervin. He works with Lee Perry. And since I've been with the Wailers, I've been having nothing but a great time, you know. Bob's been an inspiration to me. And before I joined the Wailers, it was my favorite band. So for me, it's like a dream come true, you know.
Okay, let's get one final word from Bob before we conclude this interview. Bob, is there anything special you'd like to say to the brothers? Because this interview will be on the radio station and...
We want to let the brothers know that 1980 is the golden jubilee of his Imperial Majesty Emperor. Celebration in Jamaica starting sometime in the middle of the year, you know, for the golden jubilee. So I want everyone to be conscious that now is the black man jubilee time, 50 years since His Majesty come upon the throne in Ethiopia.
Bob, why haven't you been doing concerts in the smaller islands? Is it because it's not economically feasible?
Economically feasible, I wouldn't say that, because we don't run no money. Money is fuckery. Money is the root of all evil. See? So we don't make music for money.
Would you come to St. Martin sometime and have a concert?
Of course we would come to St. Martin.
That's what I want.
When we are invited and with the proper equipment. I mean, you just can't say, Bob, can you come to St. Martin? And then nobody in St. Martin arranging it. It's not like that. It's not rain. It has to be arranged.
You got to have the right equipment, right sound
equipment. Yeah. Not even the best, but some equipment, you know, that can get the show or whoever.
Bob, it's very important that you clear up this point, because a lot of people feel that you don't come down to these small islands
to play. There's a lot of points I want to clean up with these people, man. Rastafari is God Almighty with no apology, you know. And we're not boasty, but we're proud to know that God black, you know. Just that, we just feel brave to know that God black.
We don't skin up.
And you know, and the black people, the suffering people, the first shall be the last, and the last first. But I say, though we are the sufferers today, God black, so we going to become a good people.
Well,
you understand, Skipper?
Thank you very much.
One thing we have to say, if the leaders in the world were smoking herb, them would have passed the rightful law, but right now, them not deal with nothing.
Dave Douglas, 77 News, talking to Bob Marley, Jacob Killer Miller, and Junior Marvin.
Rastafari!
And tell them people, be nice, you know, because needless the government try pressure the youth. Because we know the youth of St. Martin is Rasta. Every black man in the West Indies is black. Marcus Garvey said, half a cup of Africans are women abroad. The Ethiopian can't change him skin. Neither the leopard can change his spots, you know. So once you're black, you represent Africa.
Don't care where you're born.
See you.
Just that. It's easy.
Love,
and we must be proud of it.
Proud of yourself,
God,
man.
God black, no.
Don't see that.
It's not white Christ. When poor Paul, when they make Jesus Christ to be a white man, that was just suiting the white man ways. But in reality, God black. You know? And the way God black, God no boast. And come show you, say, well, I am God and blah, blah. It's we have to make him out. And we say, that humble one there is God, you know. Doing.
Yeah,
he's not going to come and say, I am God.
Some white house, that is Zion, some angels. That deal's done with, man. Rastafari, we are deal with the purse. Yeah, man. What is country name? St. Martin's.
Yeah.
All black people in St. Martin's learn this. We come to change the mood and teach the rightful law, which is God law, not man law. Man law is suitable for man. And man is a society who thinks of them, they make the society for themselves, you know. And I come to break down all of that. Rastafari.
See?
It's true. And one more thing. We're glad you came.
Yeah. We're glad you are here, man.
Yeah, man. I'm
glad you're fine.
Yes,
Salad. Bob, we heard that you were supposed to have be doing a concert in Grenada, and you didn't do this concert. Why?
We would really like to do a concert in Grenada for the Grenadian people, but the way how the concert was being, put together, was that it looked as if we was going to defend Marxists, and we do not defend Marxism nor capitalism. We are strictly Rasta. You know what I mean? We independent. We don't have America to go and beg anything, nor Russia to beg anything. We prefer stand up on our own self, which is Rasta, black people rights.
Bob, you say we're living in the last days. There's going to be a big fight, I think, here in the Caribbean, islands. America's going to make a grab for some of the Caribbean islands. Russia, I think, is going to make a grab for some of the Caribbean islands. What do you have to say on this?
Well, my estimation of these two thieves is that Russia and America is two of the biggest fucking friends. And all I'm doing is working a psychological warfare upon the poor people, that the people think that they're going to be a war while these fuckers come in and control. If it's not America control, it's going to be Russia. And two of them is the same thing, brother. Two of them is the same thing. It's just two fucking white men who have them ways of controlling black people. Black people time, no! Black people time, no!
Right now. Them man they come like Eccle and Jekyll. Them two brother there, America and Russia. Eccle and blood clot Jekyll. Seeing, that means we don't want no more of that. You as a black man stand up for your right. Can we come see German and French? And with the black man, they're not a meager. You know, see it. So what wanna do? Stand up and watch the French and the German take over. And I yes, where the sound come from. Africa, we are dealing with, but not to defend yourself as long as you're there.
We have a right to live. You know, we have a right to live. All of these people, who them people praising, was babies once. Babies. Mother feed them on the breast, they shit up themselves, and mother clean them. And today, them is big leaders. Nothing wrong about that, but there's still children born in today, too. And these children have modern ideas about how life should go. And I mean, we can't make some guys who used to live in the 17th century tell us what to do in this 1980s. We are young people. We must decide our own destiny because that is gone. So what? God only make two good people. We good too. We must can decide our own. We are good.
Do you have any new material coming out in the next couple of months?
Yes, we're working on. But Jacob having stuff ready, I think.
Yeah, man.
What you got?
We have two albums coming out, which is In a Circle, and we have Jacob Killer Miller coming out. So we have two albums coming out right now.
I would like to extend a personal invitation for you to get back here and do a show, man. Because I saw you on 16 Millimeter.
Me personally?
Yes, I think you really tear up the Caribbean. The Caribbean love you, Jacob.
Yeah, well, let's say me personally, me and my brother Bob Marley.
So you all are moving together now?
Yeah, well, full-time moving together because, see, right now, my materials, which he has his company getting together, where I make sure anything I'm doing coming through Tough Gang International, because if the unity of the Rastaman don't get firm, then nothing can work. And the pull cross, I'm see some guy I deal with Batty Boy and all them things, them can't work.
Tell me, what about your studio in Jamaica, Bob? What are some of the what are some of the Jamaica, Bob? What are some of the what are some of the artists and talent you've got on the Tough Gang?
Well, as you know, that the artists in Jamaica, most of them really have good heart. It's very, very good-hearted people. As you know, Toots, Burning Spear, everybody come to Tough Gang, you know, and everybody that like us to do a good job, you know. So the artist is very together. The artist, there's no problem with the artist in Jamaica. Only a few artists who is trying to be better than the other man. And we never tell nobody that we better than anyone. God give us a talent. We never beg God the talent. God give it to us and send us to do our work. And you have to fight and say, it's not we should I get the work, it's not we should I get the work, you know. Yes, it's we, God, get the work. You know what I mean?
Well, well, let's look out for the new album.
The new shot, Ball with a Chick, huh?
My name's
The Daughter.
Oh.
I hear you hover around the daughter.
Oh, well, as you know, that sisters, man. I mean, fuck, man. What should I do? Yeah, you know, try my best to stay away as much as I can, you know. But you know, Edgar, the sisters, God put them here for us to love.